and move on to the reading that I'm going to do. Well, I'm reading the second epistle from Joseph to the Corinthians by Robert Salter. Just need to get into the character. Put the brake on, because wheeling up, down to the right when you're muffing about, when you're reading something, it's quite good to stay still, especially for the camera. Hello, Facebook. How are you?
Hello.
Hello, Facebook.
You too.
Right, here we go. Dear Corinthians, I acknowledge the safe receipt of your epistle in response to my epistle, commonly known for reasons that escape me, as the first epistle to the Corinthians. Concerning the recent sojourn of my wife Mary in Bethlehem, or as your brochure puts it, the city of David. Now, for a travel company of repute, both Mary and I find your explanations for the accommodation arrangements far unsatisfactory. If we have to make the journey again, which I really hope we do not, in light of what occurred once we were there, it will most certainly not be with the Corinthians 1830 holidays. I offer the following response to your explanations. One, I have looked at the brochure and I do not agree that the description of the inn includes the outhouses. The words travellers with cattle can expect to use the stables surely refers to the cattle, not the guests. You may say that there are many worse off than ourselves, but unfortunately, they all seem to have booked with your company too. Two, you will have to take it from me that Mary giving birth to the Son of God was totally unexpected. And I can assure you that had I known that he was on the way, I would have given you the opportunity of bringing in your PR people. Three, I agree with your proposition that from every point of view, the story has more appeal set in a stable rather than in the twin bedded room with half board which we had booked. I also agree that it was much more convenient for the angel to make his way across the yard and into the stable rather than going through the residence lounge. Of course, I accept that the presence of the entire heavenly host praising God along the corridor of the second floor of the inn might have resulted in complaints from the guests, but that does not address my main complaint. My wife Mary has little in common with shepherds. It was bad enough having to cope with the livestock in the stable, but having to face a deputation of local sheep farmers who claimed they were tired of abiding their fields at night was not our idea of local colour. Your decision to include them as an optional extra in next year's brochure does not impress. Four, I know you argue that you had anything to do with the couriers who arrived from the East bearing gifts, but I still maintain that I had seen one of them in your office when I booked the trip. I do not wish to appear ungrateful, but at a time when I was struggling for an exhausted wife, a group of fanatic shepherds, assorted livestock, an angel explaining that my son was the everlasting father, and the entire heavenly host, the arrival of three Corinthian holiday reps in fancy dress did little to help. And by the way, they could have at least left something a little more practical. Anyway, thank you very much for listening.